In this practice, a disc with radius of 10 cm rotates at 1000 revolutions per minute about its central axis. The first question is determine the tangential speed at a point 5 cm from its center. Second question is determine the radial accelerations of a point on the limbs. Third question is calculate the total distance at a point on the limb moves in 1 second. So it's better to draw the figures. The disk with a radius of 10 centimeters. So you could write this is R, 10 centimeters. And then it's rotate around the axis. So omega can be calculated. It's 1000 revolution per minute. So you can convert to the radian per second. So 1000 revolution per minute equal 2 pi times 1000. And minutes to the 60 seconds. So this is radian per second. So it becomes 100 over 3 pi radian per second. This is angular velocities of a disk. Once you have these numbers, you can start to solve the questions. Number one, tangential speed at a point of the 5 centimeters. So velocity is expressed R omega. This is R is 5 centimeters. So it becomes 0.05 meter times 100 over 3 pi radian per second. Then you can calculate. It becomes 5.24 meter per second. This is the answer to the first question. And the second question is accelerations. Determine the radial acceleration of a point on the limbs. So in this case, you can express R omega squared. This is accelerations. Also, you can express, maybe you might be familiar with V squared over R. And V, actually V is, in this case, is V is R omega. So you can consider some point on the limbs. The velocity is a capital B. Okay, so this is R. R omega. Acceleration can be expressed as V squared over R, or capital R omega squared. Then you can substitute. R is 0.1 meters because 10 centimeters. We convert centimeter to the meters. And 100 over 3 pi squares. Radian per second squares. Then you can calculate. It becomes 1.10 times 1000 meter per second square. Okay, this is accelerations at over a point on the limbs. And the question number three is, the total distance a point on the limb moves in 1 second. So distance, it becomes V times T. V is R omega. So you can use this expression this here. And t is 1 second. So you can substitute 0.1 meter times 100 pi over 3 times radian per second times 1 second. Then it becomes 10.5 meters. This is the answer to the third question. Okay, this is the end of this practice.